if you have decided that many ESG metrics are better because it gives you more opportunity to motivate your employees doing the right thing for longer term profit than just this year, we have developed a solution for you, how to actually accommodate more metrics than just 1 to 3, as we have seen in practical examples today in Switzerland. First, we need to remember profit isn't a single metric either. A lot of people looking at ESG compensation now say like, yeah, but on the financial side, we have profit. And you know, we want to have one metric for the ESG side as well. But profit is not a single metric. It's actually a consolidated metric, you know, and you can see here what flows into profit. You know, it's marketing aspects, it's R&D, it's production, it's administration. There's a lot flowing into profit, which means a lot of people are actually affected by the profit metric at the end. Marketing people need to efficiently communicate the product. The production people need to effectively produce it. And the R&D department needs to be as commercially innovative as possible. So when we look at the financial side, where only 2 or 3 metrics are used, these are consolidated metrics. And the case we're making here is do the same for ESG metrics. Strive for what something that we have put here on the right side with all the acronyms that are used today to display more sustainable or even just more long-term performance measurement. Try to consolidate these metrics, and our triple bottom line approach is really a method how you can consolidate that. And this gives you a couple of advantages with the Obermott triple bottom line metrics. It actually enables you to use non-financial metrics, which are now called ESG, but they could just as well be called balanced scorecard, or they could be called qualitative metrics. It enables you to actually add these metrics to your performance management system, and it helps you consolidate all these diverse metrics into a common denominator, a little bit similar like corporate profit. And we believe you benefit if you use a triple bottom line statement using the Obermott approach with a lot more diversification in how you look at your performance, and that means less risk. It also means, and maybe that's quickly forgotten, if you just use one metric like accident rates, you only address the people in your production process. If you use more metrics, you can address a much bigger audience of your employees. Much more people are then affected by increasing your overall ESG performance. And finally, you also have a much better narrative with shareholders because they know it's not about cherry picking. It's about the future, about long-term profits.